The Christian fundamentalist is intrusive, ignorant, and definitely annoying. But are they really dangerous? Stay tuned and I'll tell you why I think the fundamentalists in America are more dangerous than ever. This is only the fourth video on my channel, but if you've watched any of my previous ones, you have figured out that I don't like Christian fundamentalists. It's true. I don't like fundamentalists. I won't be friends with them. And it's not just their absolute ignorance, annoying behavior, and intrusion. I see them as a potential threat in this country. Well, first of all, I'm an avid student of history. In earlier times, fundamentalism has dominated entire empires, including our new empire in the Northeast. The Puritans, who ironically broke from the Church of England so they could flee and practice their own beliefs, engaged in the exact same oppression that they fled from. The Puritan churches of the Northeast dominated every aspect of your life. Much of the diluted strains of spiritual guilt that we still carry today comes from our ancestors of the Puritan sect. As a matter of fact, the Puritans are a prime example of what happens when you get too close to that Bible. In 1692, it resulted in mass trials in Salem, Massachusetts, where many people were executed for being so-called witches, because children, who they believed were filled with the Holy Spirit, declared it so. Oh, but that was just the Puritans in one year, you say. Really? The Catholic faith itself was at one time very fundamentalistic. It resulted in an Inquisition, most notably in Spain, whose effect led to 32,000 people being executed for being heretics, because the church said so. This is no different than what the Taliban is doing today. They're just a few hundred years behind the Catholics, that's all. Christians in earlier times even attacked fellow Christians. Just ask the Poles, who lived in the early 1400s as the Teutonic Knights invaded. Because the most dangerous group on earth has been and always will be the group that has a cause and is backed by religion. And it's not the liberal religions that engage in atrocities of their fellow man. It's the fundamentalists. And remember, this is only a few hundred years ago. Not a lot of time in the grand scheme of things. Although maybe more educated and technologically advanced, the nature of man remains the same, whether in 1400 or 2022. But what are the Christian fundamentalists really doing today that gives such cause for alarm, you might ask? After all, the Pope has been removed from his position of power and influence. They can't burn me at the stake for giving the church the finger, because even though the Catholic power has diminished and there's no longer a Puritan sect that has control over every aspect of your life, the Christian fundamentalist churches still try to exude power whenever they get a chance. We had to go to the Supreme Court in 1987 in the case Aguilar versus Edwards, because the Christian fundamentalists in Louisiana wanted to teach creationism in the publicly funded schools, which has zero basis in any scientific thought whatsoever and is based solely on the writings of the Bible. And there have been multiple cases since then where the fundamentalist continues to try to intrude in the public school system. Look at Ralph Reed, a high-ranking executive officer of the Christian Coalition of the 1990s. I saw him on television state that he wanted his group to have a small voice in government. No, Mr. Reed, that falls under separation of church and state. And for a conservative-minded person, you would think you would know that. But the conservative fundamentalists believe in hands-off our right, except when it applies to their church, because they believe they have the God-given duty to evangelize, whether you like it or not. So we know you're trying to get involved in the government, and we know you're trying to get involved in the public school system. You wonder why I didn't vote for the Sarah Palin ticket when she was running for vice president? Because if she actually became president, she would write an executive order attempting to mandate that creationism be taught and a morning prayer be part of every school day. Oh, you don't think she would do that? When she was the mayor of Wasilla, she tried to have the librarian fired because Palin wanted to remove certain books that she deemed were immoral, backed by her faith in the Bible and God. So don't tell me the Christian fundamentalist isn't trying to push for control already. Now, many of you will state that we have nothing to worry about because the Puritans are a thing of the past. If you look at a Mormon or Jehovah Witness church, their elders would have no problem showing up to your doorstep and telling you it's inappropriate for your girlfriend to be over past 10 o'clock at night. You know how I know that? Because I know Jehovah Witnesses and Mormons. Now, you might say, okay, all this behavior is annoying, but there really isn't any threat, and that pesky Taliban is overseas after all. Yeah, that's true. Today, there's not a threat. But we're possibly on a precipice for economic collapse in this country. You can't get in debt like we are and think everything's gonna work out just fine. Whether in our lives or our children's, hard times are coming. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. And when the economy collapses, people are gonna go into a state of panic. And you know what happens when people get scared? Stephen King had an interesting novelette called The Mist, which was made into a movie. These creatures that came with the fog trapped some people inside of a supermarket. Well, they had one lady in the supermarket who was a fundamentalist. And she started pontificating on her soapbox that these tentacles trying to drag people outside to devour them alive was God's punishment on the human race. People didn't listen to her the first couple days, but after a couple more, pretty soon she had a following. And that following grew because people were scared. People turn to that Hail Mary pass when they're scared. If you place people in a state of total panic and fear, that's when the Christian fundamentalist is going to have his biggest recruitment. And if you get enough of them that take control in certain regions of the country, as our nation is collapsing all around us, pretty soon there's new leaders, and this time it's from the church. And with new leaders come new laws, and with new laws comes persecution of the non-believer. And people will fall into line if they're scared enough. Pretty soon they're telling people how to dress, how to talk, and putting people in prison for adultery. And right now you're shaking your head saying that can never happen, but you forget it's happened before. And it's only been a couple hundred years. And it's happening across the pond right now with a different branch of fundamentalism, known as the Islamic fundamentalist. And that's why I'm so hostile towards these people. Because the Christian fundamentalist is a threat to my freedom. You have the right to practice, you don't have the right to intrude, whether you think it's for my good or not. And the problem with a group of people backed by religion who think they have the right to intrude, if they ever gain any sort of power whatsoever, they will intrude by force, backed by their flaming sword of or else. So no, Christian fundamentalist, I don't think you're just annoying. I think you're a future danger that all of us non-fundamentalists better keep our eye on. Because knowing the nature of man like I do, I can see Stephen King's fictional fundamentalism coming to life on a large scale. And speaking of apocalypse, if you'd like to read about an offbeat one of what I think it would be like if Christ ever actually returned, check out my book on Amazon, The Second Fall. Highly irreverent and sure to offend the fundamentalist. Link is in the video description below and banner above. And I'll see you next time as we take that sword of reason and reality and thrust it right into the heart of ignorance once again.